Welcome to sunny Winterhaven in Florida. I'm Dog Bowers, and I want to talk to you and inspire you with some great tips about how to unleash your barefoot water skiing potential. As always, I like to start off with good quotes, and could possibly be the best day ever, and the forecast for tomorrow is 6% better. I know I say that all the time. Our motto here is expect a miracle. We expect a miracle for you in your barefooting. We expect a miracle for you in your health. And let's start off with a great quote. Look at this. I even wrote it down for you guys. Look at that. Posture, glide, and power band. That's going to be the topic and how to unleash your potential in your barefoot water skiing. And I love this quote from Tony Robbins. Begin to live your life as if your prayers have already been answered. And I love the fact, there it is right there if you want to see it. We're talking a little bit, I like the quote from Tony Robbins because Tony Robbins is actually the guy many years ago when I was living in the bunk beds of Barefoot International down in Lantana, Florida, when Mike Seipel was inspiring me and getting me started in my barefooting career. I was reading a book called Unleash the Giant Within. I highly recommend that book to you. It's a great book by Tony Robbins, and it really inspired me. He got into some kind of techie stuff called neuro-linguistic programming, but, and again, I'm not a scientist, but my take on that and what I took away from that was that you could change your state or the way you feel, the way you act. And if you consistently change that state, you will change your entire future. And you can achieve your goals by getting into a state that is more conducive for the kind of person that you want to be, not for where you're at or reality of right now. What was really interesting in there is that he talked about a lady who paid tens of thousands of dollars to get a private session with him. And I'll summarize it like this. She came in and her life was a shambles. And so as he sits across from her with all these horrible problems, he says, okay, tell me what's going on. And she immediately went from, you know, kind of excited being around Tony Robbins to kind of slumped over. And she just started wailing and crying and explaining how the difficulties with her husband, the difficulties with her marriage. And then Tony Robbins says, stop. She's like kind of freaked out, taken aback. And he says, sit up. And she's like, what? He goes, sit up straight. Pull your shoulders back. Hike your ribs up. He said, all right. He said, now go ahead. Tell me what you were saying. Boom. And then she started crying and telling him about everything that he interrupts her again. Stop it. And she's like, what are you talking about? Said, sit up straight. Pull your shoulders back, chest out, breathe in through your nose. One more time. All right, go ahead. Tell me, what were you saying? This goes on a little bit. And what was interesting is that if he got her to go every time she talked about her problems in her life and the things that there were real problems, she would slump. She would assume this depressed posture. She real shallow breathing, whiny voice. And Tony changed her state by physically changing first, not her head, but physically changing her posture. Different than slumping it like this all day and kind of typing with your head all postured out, weird neck position and all that. This got me thinking. As I was sitting there, at this time, I can't remember what, I think I was literally starting to do my feet-to-feet toe turns, which at that point, no one in the world could do them. Mike Seipel could do one of them. And I was working on some very difficult tricks for me at the time. And it doesn't matter. This applies to anybody from learning to barefoot, learning to backwards barefoot, whatever your goals are. I'm going to tell you my story about how you apply that. I started to realize when I would go into whatever was difficult for me, for at this time, like say feet to feet toe turns, no one in the world was doing it. So when I would put my foot in that strap and I'd be flying down the lake at some hellacious speed with a bear trap on, not what they were using today where it doesn't lock on your foot. This locked on your foot. I guarantee you that I was in a state of more, my body position, if we could have looked at it before I understood this and after I understood this, was a totally different state. Now, I'm not saying if you get in a great position, you're not going to fall, but it was the foundational shift in my life that affected my barefooting forever. Another way for some of you advanced barefooters thinking about is coming into the jump. You think you know a good position until you come into the jump, and all of a sudden stuff is thrown out the window because as you're flying into that ramp, if you've never done that, and most of you probably won't, but it's a great example, is there is nothing difficult about barefoot jumping except holding your position, a great position, the world's most powerful position, and then learning to raise. We teach it on the boom so that it's safer. So if something were to go wrong, you have the safety of holding onto a high boom. But the point is this, if you come into that ramp in any way, I can tell when I'm pulling someone skiing or barefooting what they're thinking by how they're positioned. An example would be, let's take a simpler example, is you come here and you say, I want to do my one foots and, you know, they're I can kind of do it, but not really good. And I definitely, my weak foot is really hard, or it could be toe holds or back toe holds. It could be front to backs or reverse turns. The same thing. Just use it for your scenario. Someone goes into, I'll get them into position, what I call a great position. I'll go over posture, glide, and power band. I'm a little off track, but I'll get them in a great position. As soon as they try the thing that's most difficult for them, let's say it's a one foot, what happens is they sit down, they lose their posture, and then they start it's hard because I need to get some of these out there in the boat, but you can see like they'll flex, sit lower, and push on their foot. All a much more difficult position to even begin a one foot. Okay, so here's what I started to realize. Why, and this is the, I hope you get this epiphany. I hope that you walk away from this with so much power that you, number one, apply it to, even if you're sitting at a desk or doing something mundane, I want you to practice this. I came up with posture, glide, and then later on power band because I wanted to emulate the world's best barefooters. So at that time, it was Mike Seipel. Literally, he's just, he's nervous. Happened. It already is. But I said, what if I come into this trick and I act as if I am already a master at this? How would I look differently? Not the trick itself. Everything up to that trick is the thing we can control. So everything up to that trick is very easily controllable by simply getting in a great position. And this is where I found out the power of posture. When he said, told that lady to pull her shoulders back and stick her chest out and sit up straight and breathe, there's a fundamental shift that goes on, not in only in your physical body, it's directly tied to how you think. All you got to do is practice yourself. The upper body form for posture, glide, and barefooting are the three most powerful concepts that were ever introduced into barefoot water skiing. I published those a long time ago. The truth of it is not, and I'm not saying this out of pride, it's just common sense, is that a powerful position will give you a much more powerful result. Okay. So now let's go and practice just the posture glide and power band. This will affect everything you do. And if you can learn to approach anything in barefooting or in life with this change of state, you will absolutely unleash your personal potential in whatever you're doing. But for me, because I knew I didn't want to fall real hard, I really wanted to be the first guy in the world to do all four feet-to-feet toe turns, and I was scared, but I wanted to do it. So I was like, how can I now this is different. I'm going to post a funny video after this one when on our website, but this is different from positive thinking. I think I can. And then you just put your foot in your strap and you do a toe hold and you just try a toe turn. That is not what we're talking about. You do have to find the homework, do the practice. Is my basics for this are always practice on dry land so you can get in the right position. Practice on shoe skis for the more difficult things, as in surface turns and maybe jumping, not always. Not for learning to barefoot, not necessarily for one foots, not necessarily for backwards, not necessarily for back one foots. But this does not apply. And it's not like have a positive attitude and go try something super difficult, because you will get creamed if you do that. That is not what we're talking about. I'm talking about let's find out first what is the world's most powerful position for you. Insert your name in this, you know, no matter who it is. Put your name in it. If it's Michael, put Michael's name in it. So what is the world's most powerful position for Michael? I'll practice this there. Shoulder roll, meat hook, I call it. Because when I first started teaching posture to myself and then to my students, I found out if I just said get in good posture, some people would have their shoulders forward and they kind of stick their chest up, but this isn't good posture. So I kind of had to figure out after a while of teaching it to hundreds and then thousands of people, that if you rolled your shoulders back, which is kind of the words Tony used, a little different, Tony Robbins, roll your shoulders back. I call it meat hook. Pretend you got a hook coming underneath your ribs, hike your ribs up. That shoulder roll meat hook, this upper body is here, but is your feet gliding on the water. The way you glide is by flexing your ankles, and they need to be underneath. So from a side view, you've got your knee, if this is your toes facing that way, most people barefoot with their feet way out in front of them. Maybe I do it this way towards the camera. I got to go this way. Your feet are out in front, and here's your knee way back here. So you kind of got your shin bones at an angle like this. You want to get your foot under, let me show it sideways like that. So your knee is kind of over top. If I drop a plumb line from the end of my knee, my ankle is slightly behind it. That's what world-class barefooting glide is. Every little bit forward your feet are actually increases resistance that comes up the line, makes everything more difficult. Plus, it can be unsafe. So the glide, we'll talk kind of about that. But the posture is the shoulder roll meat hook. The power band is learning to ski with your hips towards the handle. If you're backwards, your butt is kind of pushed out. It's more naturally into the handle. But we'll go over all that in a separate video. But the thing I want you to understand is this. What amazing thing could you accomplish if you were 100% certain of the very least that you could get into the perfect world-class position? My goal for any student that I have, and even if I don't coach you personally, I'm not telling you to come down here. You don't have to come down and see me. I can help you for free online, or you can use our virtual ski school where I take your videos and personally analyze stuff and send it back to you. But you could do this with this free information here, right here. What if you got in the world's most perfect and powerful position, and you understood that without a doubt? Don't you think that would have a great impact on your skiing? I personally know that it does, because almost everyone I get down here needs a couple little tweaks to get the perfect standing position. Now, you don't have to be a perfectionist to do this, but let's face it. If you are in a position that is heavier on the water, a lot of times that comes from plowing, from sitting too low, or being out of position, or diving away, some of these little things, the amount of force that's coming through you, you can't see in my arm, but like the amount of force that's coming up the handle and into my body is way higher than it is when your butt is up higher, let's say in a forward position, your feet are underneath you, but you're not light and in danger coming out the front because you got your hips forward into the handle, you got your shoulders back, so it'd be a little more like this with your shoulders back and your hips forward. You can't really see it, but roughly. So what that powerful position is the foundation for doing anything great that you want. When you learn to get into that, and if it's cold where you're at, you could do this, put hook a handle on a doorknob and practice shoulder roll, meat hook, hips up, feet underneath you. Send us a couple snapshots or a video of it, and I'll take a look at it. But here's the deal. Getting in that position dramatically affects your outcome of what you do. So posture, glide, and power band all came out of reading NLP stuff from Tony Robbins, another neuro-linguistic programming. That all was basically, if you could change and get into the mindset of a world champion, you know, my personal belief is you are a trillion-dollar machine. The only difference, I mean, I would net anyone who comes to see me, anyone who watches this, the bare minimum I want you to go away with is that you can stand in world-class form. Your standing position, you have no excuse not to have as great of a position as me. This isn't a 10-year process of slowly knocking out all the bad habits. This should be a like 10-minute process at least on dry land, and then get it in the easiest next position. If it's on the boom in a swing, which is what I prefer to do to help people learn to barefoot at slow speeds and without falling, that's what you do. If you're super confident on the short rope, show me a perfect position there, hips up and forward. You should be able to ski light. If you can't ski below 30 miles an hour, chances are you aren't even close to being in a world-class position. Backwards, you should be able to easily ski. If you're a beginner at 23 to 25 miles an hour, if you're more advanced, probably 30 and above. But the point is, you should be able to get in a great position, and then you should be able to breathe, smile, have your hands relaxed, but your body position powerful. So posture, glide, and power band. That's what I want to talk to you about. That's what I want to inspire you guys about. And I'm going to post some of my other articles underneath this when we put it on our blog, on our website, along with a really funny video. I gotta find it, of a guy on the internet who's apparently he went and got all fired up, kind of like, and I want you guys to understand, this is not only a get fired up, get positive, a positive mental attitude, and then go try something real difficult and kill yourself. So this guy, he's on his dad, I think, is filming him, and he's like a 20-something-year-old guy, maybe he's 30. And it appears that he's living at home. He takes some womanized reinforced plywood, and he now gives a motivational speech of, you got to believe that you can do it, and then you got to execute. I don't have it verbatim. And then he's trying to take this literally waterproof board that you couldn't beat, that would be hard to break through with a hatchet, and he starts trying to smash it over his head. And then when he can't do it, he's about knocked himself out. And he's like, okay, apparently, you know, I know what I want to do. I've got to commit to it more. And he just keeps trying harder. That isn't smart. You know what I mean? That is not what we're talking about here. What I'm talking about here is the unleashing your potential by the very minimum of knowing what a world-class position is. So I hope this inspired you guys today. I'm going to put this up on the website. And the way some of you guys are thinking, you might be tuning out and going, I already know how to barefoot forwards. I know how to barefoot backwards. All I want is the hard stuff. Show me the surface turns. You show me almost 90% of the people, more than 90% of the people that I run into who have problems with surface turns. When we get on the water and they show me their surface turn, like say they can do one way or they can't do it, if I video and slow-mo everything up to, but take out the trick itself, but everything, so the setup position, down, up, and go, if I follow that, I promise you, if they're having problems with their turns, their body position is broken down. So for you advanced barefooters out there who want to do 1 foot turns, toe turns, or 2 foot turns, or reverses, or whatever you want to do, I can guarantee you, take this to the bank. It's $500 of free lessons right here. Fix your position. Don't get out of a world-class position. Then show me what you're doing. And I promise you, you'll be able to ski slower, safer, and with much better results and accomplish anything that your heart desires, as long as you got good information and take the baby steps to get there. But the baby steps are getting in position, practicing your position under a little bit of stress. So that might be for someone working on a front to back, for example, I would have them practice. Show me your 1 foot in world-class form. Show me your toe holds in world-class form. Show me bouncy trounce. It's a whole nother thing, a whole separate thing on that. But this unleashes your potential. This isn't a you and you can accomplish. Show me your world-class position, and I will help you unleash your I'll help you unleash your barefooting miracle. All right. God bless you guys today. I hope you enjoyed this. Leave me a comment and do me a favor. I know this is good timing for most people, but I need to get this stuff out. And I'm probably going to be doing another live presentation on Friday. We got a lot of people who want backwards barefooting stuff. So we're going to do a whole backwards barefooting thing, either Thursday or Friday. I'll try and time it so I give you guys a notification and a reminder so you guys can share it if you want to be on here live. But the main thing about this is I need to get this stuff out there, and then you guys can watch it whenever you want. So God bless you guys. I hope you're excited about this. Please leave me a comment. Please share this with other people. I'm making this stuff free. I'm spending my time doing this. I want to help you guys, so do me a favor and share the information. Get people to sign up and go to thefootersedge.com. Get my free ebook, Be the Best Barefooter on Your Lake. And we're expecting a miracle for you. God bless you. Have a great day.